Today's Coyotes Driven In puts us in Sanderson Ford's F-150 Raptor. You know, the leaner, meaner 2019 Raptor is nearly 500 pounds lighter than the previous generation. With a military-grade aluminum alloy body, it has the strength and tech to off-road, rock climb, you name it. But my mission today is of the humble variety. I've got to get two Coyotes teammates from home to practice on time or face the ire of their coach. My first stop, Coyotes center and alternate captain, Derek Stepan.
Hey, Derek.
All right.
Come on in.
This is awesome.
Just
what a
normal,
nice ride.
Just a normal day, me
yeah,
picking you up
this.
To head to the arena.
Best way to get to the rink ever.
This Raptor is pretty sweet, isn't it?
I know. Maybe you can take it off-road after you drop me off.
That would be fun. Do you drive a truck?
I drive a SUV? Denali, yeah, SUV. Yeah.
I mean, this drives so smooth. Now, my voice is a little raspy. I don't know how you guys turn right around after a game, and then you're back at practice, you know, today. And I guess I've just been doing too much broadcasting.
Yeah, you know
so
what?
So pardon that. But
that's okay. That's all right. You're busy. Busy work is always good work.
So we're picking up Jason Demers.
Yep.
Do I make a left?
Yeah, you're going to go left here.
So, you know, you have kids, so how does your morning go? Do you get to sleep in at all, or?
Yeah, you know what, actually, I'm spoiled right here. Yeah, take it right here, and then it's your next right.
Okay, perfect.
I'm spoiled right now. My family's actually back in Minnesota, so I have the house alone, just with the dog, so I've been doing a lot of-
So you get to sleep a little more.
Got a little more sleep. I know my wife's a little jealous. You're gonna take it right here.
Okay.
But yeah, they went back to Minnesota to experience some fall stuff, because we had my daughter down here, so she hasn't really even witnessed any cold weather yet. So,
yeah. Well, fall here means, you know, it's 90.
So. Yeah. Growing up in Minnesota, it's definitely a different animal than being in Scottsdale, I can tell you that much.
Is there anything you miss about the cold, actually? Or?
Yeah, I kind of do miss a little bit of the fall. I don't miss the winter whatsoever.
Yeah.
Like, there's no way I miss any of that, but... that fall weather where you can wear, you know, sweatpants and sweatshirts everywhere. Yeah. I do kind of miss that a little bit.
So normally, though, you drive yourself in?
No,
or
actually.
Or do you come in with a guy?
Well, for games, weekday games, it's nice to carpool because the traffic gets a little thick. So we're actually, I usually pick up Goose. Me and Goose ride together pretty much. It's nice, too, because our wives, if we one of us drives and the other wife can pick up the other one, and so
makes
we can
sense.
Then we each have our own cars
I
afterwards.
Like carpooling, it's good for the environment too.
That's right And then practice days I'll probably drive myself most of the time, just because if I want to get out of there, if I want to hang out a little bit more, you know, I have the luxury of not having to worry about it. But yeah, me and Goose usually ride together. Me and Goose spend a lot of time together.
Yeah, I can see that, you know.
Yeah, but. A couple Minnesota boys.
But, you know, you do have so many young guys. I'm sure that's kind of fun, too. But, you know, maybe when it comes to hanging out, you hang out with older guys.
We really do have a great balance, older guys and young guys mixtures. And I think what's really great about this year is our younger guys are, you know, they're more, I would say they're past the young stage now. And they're still young, but they've been around now 3 years, so they're, you know, they've taken big steps and learning how to be a pro. So we got a great balance of the group, and our older guys are, you know, I like to think that we steer the ship a little bit, but
that's how it should
be, right? Our
younger
guys bring the energy, and it's like I said, it's a good balance.
So you have your morning coffee. What else is your morning ritual, really? What does it entail?
Well, normally, the kids are here. Like a day like today, wake up with the kids and hang out with them for a little bit. Friday, Max has school, my oldest.
Okay.
So he has school, so if I'm able to take him, I try to take him to school. And my daughter, Wesley, she's got a lot of spunk to her, so she usually is a handful in the morning.
How old is she?
She's two, and my son will be four next week, actually. So.
Yeah, two, they're really active, always kind of getting into stuff, right? So.
Yeah, and especially her. She's a classic second child, I'll tell you what.
She's trying to get that attention.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know where she gets the attitude from. I think it's probably from me, not my wife.
And, you know, the attitude doesn't really change, but.
I know. You know what? You know. I'll say it. here on Fox Sports, I'm in trouble when she gets older. Plain and simple. That's
Does she run the house?
100%.
Yeah.
We were really lucky. We had two great babies, but Wes, she's the boss. There's no doubt about it.
And that's, you know what? There are some good things about that too.
Oh, absolutely. I'm completely okay with it.
She knows her mind then, and she's
I'm okay with it. As long as she knows that mom actually runs the house and that she can just bark orders every once in a while. Me and my son are right with it. We know that the women in our house are the ones that steer everything.
Are you okay with me driving, by the way?
I'm completely okay with that. Good. I heard you got five stars on your...
I'm knock on wood.
Now, so Jason might have a different issue with it. I mean, Jason might tell you to go in the back, and he might be driving.
Well,
but.
You know, he wanted a limo. I said, look, the Raptor's better, actually.
Yeah, I could see JD wanting the stretch Hummer or something like that. Let's see here. I just want to double check it. He sent it to me again. Make sure we're going to the right spot.
Yeah, that would be good. I don't think we're going to be cutting it too tight, but we don't. I want to definitely,
I want to go the speed limit.
I don't want to be late
so that you have to answer to talk. That's what I want.
I'm hoping
that Fox Sports has to deal with talk.
Because, I think he would take it easy on me. I don't know. What do you think?
I'm not sure. That's why I want to see it. I want to see exactly what the breakdown is.
Today's Driven In continues in Sanderson Ford's F-150 Raptor. Our mid-morning commute finds Derek Stepan and I in the driveway of teammate Jason Demers.
I don't know if you know what you signed up for with this guy.
And there's no time to waste. Practice looms across town at Gila River Arena. The Raptor's 450-horsepower twin-turbo V6 engine should help the cause.
He's on the phone.
Yeah, I just called my publicist. Like they told me they're picking me up in a limo. I gotta go, though. I'm getting in there.
Okay, bye. Hey, what's up, guys?
Good morning, JD.
Good morning. How are you?
Doing great. How are you?
Good.
We didn't interrupt the call there.
No. It's just my agent. We're just working out some details.
Yeah, I mean, really? I thought it was the limo too, right?
Oh, yeah. No, I was in the call. I was just transferring some funds to the Cayman Islands. Things like that.
Is that a normal morning for you?
Jay, you got to get us out of here, though, because I don't
know. Oh, yeah. You just hang a left. And then
okay. So far so good, but I can't go anywhere else.
Yeah, just hang another left at the end.
At the very end, okay.
Mm-hmm. Then you're gonna go right, and right.
So you told me you don't drink coffee, so I got you a tea, but I was kind of just aiming in the dark there.
I only drink Sencha, though. Is this Sencha?
That is like a blackberry jasmine green.
I appreciate it. Thank you. That's a big tea, though.
Sencha. Did I miss that?
Awesome. It's a deep, deep joke.
It's a deep joke.
Yeah. You got to be educated for that one.
Yeah.
I'm not.
You got to be educated. Well,
that's,
your spice.
That's decent. Whole Foods, too. Oh, AJ's.
AJ's, yeah. I love AJ's.
Right here.
Which,
right
by
here.
The way, I got pastry, too, but I'm guessing you guys really aren't pastry people. You're healthy.
You're talking to the two least.
I have some croissants.
And then a right,
like.
Right here.
We probably shouldn't eat in the Raptor. What do you think of the Raptor?
You can take a right.
Okay,
yeah.
Perfect.
Right. This is nice. Yeah, it's
nice truck.
I think Chick's got something like this, right?
I don't know.
But worse?
Yeah.
But very similar?
It's like not as nice, but it's like
it's a big
yeah,
truck.
This is very spacious though. I didn't think I'd have this much
it is.
Room it's in the so back.
I'm going to try to get you guys there on time. I know Rick Tockett, he runs a tight ship.
Yeah.
So we want to get you there.
Ricky's waiting for us.
Yeah,
but you guys are happy if you're a little late and then you want to see how he reacts to me.
I would love to see that.
Because
wouldn't you like to see that?
I would like to see him yell at you.
Yeah, that's what I'm curious
he might,
to see
you know,
how he goes
I think
about
he,
it.
I think he might take it easy on me, though, but I could be wrong.
It was a carpool karaoke a bit.
Yeah.
James
would
you
Corden's
like to sing?
Gonna pop out here. not, I'd like Step to sing probably more than that.
So, and you can.
Black guys.
I have to say.
I'm gonna let the old ways die.
There you go, little Bradley Cooper.
Yeah, great movie.
Really good movie.
It is a good movie. So Barrett Hayton is living with you, which I think is terrific that you asked him to come in under your wing. I feel a little bit bad leaving him there and having to drive himself, but
it's all right.
There's some moments he needs to grow up a little bit.
He needs to learn a bit, yeah. It's about time. I'm trying to kind of wean him off the bottle, as they say.
How is it going? How is that roommateship going, though? Because,
It's more of like a father-son, not more of a roommate. It's more like JD does the groceries and the laundry and the dishes.
So he's
and
just
the cleaning
just
and the taking care, and they're paying the rent, and he just kind of floats around. He just provides the... comedy.
We know how much you talk, but I want to ask both of you. On the ice, do you guys trash talk much at all, or not at all?
You're not really my cup of tea. I actually have a lot of conversations with the refs. Try to keep that line of communication open.
Cut deals.
I just try to be nice to those guys. You know, those guys have a tough job. I think if you can talk to them normally rather than yell at them, I think it goes a long way. So that's more my conversations are with them. And every once in a while, I go off the rails and yell at them. But
yeah, it's good for them.
It's good for them. I think we have good I have good relationships with them. But JD doesn't really trash talk.
I don't know if it's trash
talk.
I guess I meant more talking to the guys. I see players talking all the time.
It's rare. Yeah. But if I do, I'm throwing daggers.
Yes.
But no, I like to kind of just yell on the bench, and it keeps me in it. And I enjoy talking with the refs too. It's the older you get in the league, you realize that you don't want to burn that bridge, because they'll ref out of spite sometimes. If you get mad.
You told me
something about, and I actually noticed it yesterday with Devo, is that you're telling me that if you get kicked out of the faceoff and you stand there, then the next few times they'll kick you out right away. And Devo stood there, and then they kept kicking him out after. Devo's kind of making him look stupid.
Exactly, and I think that's, like I said, I think they're, if you know the game within the game, it's as a centerman, those linesmen, there's another game within the game that you have to constantly be playing in faceoffs, because faceoffs are such a gray area where you can, sometimes you can get away with stuff, sometimes you can't.
But I guess you guys talk to the young guys about a lot of little things like that, right?
In the league, they just
have to learn it on their own too.
Little tricks you learn and things you pick up along the way that are passed down to you, and you try to kind of hand it off to them, and ways to kind of cheat the game, so to speak. Yeah.
Without actually cheating the game.
We call it demerzing the game. Who wants
to play the game straight up? Come on now.
JD's looking for every advantage he can get out there. So if there's an advantage, he's going to take it.
Exactly. Have to.
We kind of joke about you and Barrett, father, son. But on a serious note, so would you let JD babysit your kids? Could he handle that?
Ooh, I don't know. Actually, I don't know about a 2 and 4 year old.
I can handle them. I can handle them for the fun time, and then once things kind of got a little hairy, I mean, listen. At the same time, I have a niece.
I think you'd
I'd be okay.
I'd be all right, but yeah, it's a different animal. I don't think he's ever really done the changing of diapers and.
No, I have not.
Yeah, that's not that.
And
much
that's
fun.
Something that's. Have you though? I have a question. Have you?
Oh,
I mean, I feel like you have a 72-hour nanny and a 24-hour nanny and.
Speaking of daggers.
They make fun of me. But I've been dad of the year 3 years in a row. So I don't
17 know. Nannies, dad of the year, and an au pair.
Dad of the year, and I just keep winning it. So they're trying to knock me off the throne.
Driven In is presented by Sanderson Ford. The best play is at Sanderson Ford. This edition of Driven In rolls on with Derek Stepan riding shotgun and Jason Demers in the back seat of the bold and beautiful Ford Raptor. Steph and JD now in their third season together with the Coyotes.
I know a couple of guys have chefs, so do you guys have that? Or?
Oh, I'll God, this is just, open this has been JD. Lining up for just a great day for me.
Yeah. Go ahead, Jay, I'll
What's
let you
the story?
Run
I didn't even know I was no, getting I into the story.
I cook, so okay. I'm a big foodie, and I love to cook, and I mean, I cook all of my meals, if not, you know, it's that, and maybe, obviously, I enjoy going to restaurants, but, like, I cook for Barrett, and he doesn't...
Actually, I got treated, my family, like I said, is in Minnesota, and when we got back from the road trip, before the Nashville game, I went over, and JD treated me to some nice tacos, and...
Nice.
And two apples last game.
It was a pretty good meal, so, you know what? My question for you is, what's for tonight?
Oh, what's for tonight? A little Friday meal?
Friday night,
a little surf and turf?
But well, sounds good.
Blueberry reduction.
Oh yeah,
the guys say
he loves his blueberries. He's
wait, blueberry reduction on what?
On salmon.
On anything.
Oh, on salmon. And I thought cereal. You were talking about like salmon.
In his hair.
That sounds good.
Anywhere.
Well, and you know, I actually didn't.
You think it stays up in the morning?
It's my yeah. How do you think keep it up?
You could put that on pancakes. Just
you could, but yeah, I make it with a little bit of thyme, some balsamic,
a little
savory, sugar,
yeah.
And you just kind of cook them down, and then it turns into a nice little sauce.
I do remember this now. Your famous dish is the mustard-crusted salmon, right?
That is true. That is back. That's way back, yeah. Do you cook step at all?
I just grill. And I'm,
you're a grill, right?
I
just like to grill.
I wouldn't sit here and claim I'm anything other than just a guy that cooks it till it's done.
Well done.
I don't get finessed with it. I just
black.
Make it a hockey puck and away we go. But my wife does a lot of cooking for our family, and I would say that she's top notch. But I don't know if she's got quite the skill set you do, but she's pretty
wow.
good.
Wow, saying that with four cameras around too.
Yeah, I think
appreciate that, Steph. We love you.
I think you need to come over and show.
I know that's something. That's something we've talked about doing. Yeah. Is
like you doing classes.
Well, I invited him one time and
letting them have a date night and me cook. So be like the Ooh. Chef and the serve wine and be a sommelier and pair a couple things. And
I invited him over one time.
That's a good friend. Yeah.
And then I went to Goose's house instead. He come over and I didn't really hear anything back, and the next morning I get to the rink and he's like, Goose, what'd you think of my dinner I cooked for you guys? I was like, hey man, what's up?
You want like, yeah, I mean to, so have, now you have to pay it forward with stuff. You can't
they have
just
Dallas,
do it
ties.
Goose, right?
Dallas ties.
Yeah,
Dallas ties
further
have, back.
Yeah, we have known each other for a while now.
Can't compete with that.
Driven In is presented by Sanderson Ford. The best play is at Sanderson Ford.
Alexas and the whole that whole setup.
We've been.
I do not trust Alexa or Echo or any of those.
We had the Google one and it would randomly turn on and it just.
Hell no!
We unplugged
no, thank
it.
You.
We unplugged it. And we're like, we're done with it. I don't.
Someone's
I don't,
listening on the other so, end.
Yeah.
Do you trust the internet then for information?
No.
I know. I trust it for information, but like.
But not for.
I know they're
privacy.
Watching everything I'm doing.
Yeah. How about like you have a conversation and then you'll go through something
Your
and
Instagram's
it's like
the ad,
the ad is like talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't want to get into this because they are listening and then
they
all of a sudden you're going to
right
get
audited. Everyone really is watching and listening.
Yeah, and so. Then all of a sudden I'm going to get audited 3 times in 3 years, so I'm going to.
So we've given you husband of the year, dad of the year. If you were going to give Jason that he's something of the year, what would it be?
Oh, God.
What would it
Nothing.
Be?
Nothing. Jack of all trades, master of none.
I would say early on here.
Do
I'm going to say
I can't wait to hear this.
Teammate of the year right now.
Oh,
he's leading the charge.
Yeah.
He's been
I like it.
He's been a big
Took
part
in a
youngster. Of our
I
big
mean,
part of our year right now. This guy, he's the glue right now. Nice. I don't like tooting his horn too much. I don't want to get too far,
he
but
like,
he's
Look at him. Look at he's beaming with pride.
Teammate of the year. He's been a big part of you know, our group has
come a long way.
Come a long way, and I think a lot of the young guys, he's kind of that middle piece between the young guys and old guys right now.
Love
it. It's a good little spot. So I'll give him teammate of the year right now.
Wow.
Thanks,
wow,
man.
Wow.
It's one free back rub for you.
Yeah. Well, it's dinner tonight.
Oh, it's dinner tonight. Yeah.
You guys have a great group. And I know the one guy, it seems like, correct me if I'm wrong here, but one of the young guys that seems to take a lot of kind of good-natured teasing, things like that, is Connor Garland. Am I right with that? Or
he brings it on, though.
Does he bring it on?
Yeah, he takes it.
He's...
Okay, I didn't know that.
I mean, I love a guy that can take it.
You're getting off?
Yeah, you're going to go
left
here.
Left on Maryland.
I mean...
Oh, yeah, true. I come from the other direction a lot, so...
Yeah.
This thing's, you don't even have to put your blinker on it. You just go over people.
Well, I do have
with
a
With
the
few, raptor, you just...
The raptor,
there's a few
just,
more people following.
Like your road.
I just want to let them know what's up.
Yeah, but Connor gets it. I'd say the two guys that get it the most probably... Connor and Chick, and they're great sports too.
Yeah.
They're really good sports about it.
And I mean, that's.
Now, why are they good targets?
I mean, have you seen the shorts that Chick wears? I mean...
No, I've seen... he wears normal shorts, right?
No, he wears short shorts.
Oh, I did not know that.
But, I mean, Chick... It's just Chick. Like, just Chick's... But he's such a great kid, and he's just...
Yeah.
It's... You just kind of... It's fun to tease him, and he's gotten so good at... He knows that it's all in, you know, good fun, and I think same with Connor, and...
Yeah. I think that's part of the young guys growing up, too, a little bit, is maybe early on they thought that we were doing it because we didn't like them,
yeah.
And now they've... understand that it's
because you do like them.
This is part of it. This is how you. This is. I'm sure when Jay first came in the league 12 years ago, 13 years ago,
I was 15. I know Scotty Niedermeyer was in the league. I think
guys would just pick up a lot worse than.
I got it worse than I mean anyone. I think.
You did.
Oh, I mean, because I was the way I am now, back then. So sometimes it did sting a bit, but they'd always say like, if we're not talking to you, then you know something's wrong.
So we're here, guys. We made it.
We made it. We made it on time, too.
Are we on
little,
time? Because now...
A little disappointing, because I really wanted to...
I wanted to
I
see,
really wanted to see
what
Maybe
talk
we'll
would
just take
say.
A couple laps here. Yeah. Go to Blue Martini for one.
The question is, will they let me in? They know you guys. But
no, they'll...
I don't usually get to come down here into the...
You just got to give them a little... Fella!
Well, hello. Good morning.
You going to drop them off?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dropping them off.
Heck, that's good, because it's busy as heck. And by the way, good game, guys.
Hey, thanks.
Yeah. They're playing great. Oh, I know you guys said you love coming to the rink, so here we are.
This is great.
Here we are.
What do you do before the meeting?
Why don't you park over here by Talk? I never get to do it, and we got the cameras
Where is he?
Go over here. Let's get over on the front row.
Am I allowed?
With the cameras, you're definitely allowed.
Let's go right where the president
is. Yeah, let's pick one of these. Any of these are good.
Aaron won't mind.
Pick the new owner.
I'll go in the president.
I feel like we got a brass pass right now. It's just the cameras.
We're good.
Park anywhere we can be
late. Yeah, look at that.
Awesome.
Thank you so much for the ride.
Guys, thank you so much. I appreciate your time, and I hope you don't get in
trouble. What time are you picking us up tomorrow?
Yeah.
You can find today's truck, the Ford F-150 Raptor, and more than 1,000 vehicles at Sanderson Ford in Glendale, America's most awarded Ford dealership.